Have you heard of Qur'anly? It's a habit-building Qur'an app unlike anything you've seen before. The app tracks your verses, pages, time, and hasanat gained as well. I've tried it too. Take your Qur'an reading from inconsistent to finishing it twice a year with the meaning. Check out the 7-day free trial. Download it on the App Store now. Search Qur'anly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers, my sisters, some of us have a weakness of showing our emotions online, in our statuses, on posts, not realizing that the people out there are not all sincere. A lot of the times, we may be going through an issue in our lives, and we think by posting about it, by advertising it, by telling the world about it, or even by hinting to the world that I have a problem, it will solve my problem. No, it won't. In fact, it makes matters worse. People begin to think you have a problem, and yes, they may be right. But then, those who are insincere may begin to advise you wrongly. That can happen. Secondly, sometimes those who are sincere but don't have the expertise of how to resolve the matter may also advise you wrongly. That can happen too. But sometimes people seize the opportunity to spread a lot of gossip behind your back. Sometimes people spread so much slander and gossip that it becomes toxic. That itself becomes a major problem. People lose respect not just for you, but for the matter at hand. People begin to create stories. They fill the gaps with shaitan's whispers. And therefore, it's definitely not a good idea to start showing your issues, your problems to the world. Sometimes you solve your matter in a short space of time, but the world still continues to think that your problem is major and that you are in a mess. If they were to meet you 2 years later, 5 years later, or sometime later, they would still say, "Wow, I hope everything's okay. I hope you're fine. You know, I heard you had a major issue," and so on and so forth. And the problem was resolved long back. It was none of their business anyway. So to hold your cards close to your chest is definitely a teaching of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. You don't need to give every detail of your happiness or sadness to the whole world. وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِّنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَاتَّبَعْتُمُ الشَّيْطَانَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Allah Almighty speaks about how from among the qualities of the hypocrites is that they begin to announce any news or anything that happens to them or anything that comes to them, they literally advertise it. They broadcast it. Allah says, أَذَاعُوا بِهِ. إِذَاعَ means to broadcast. They broadcast the news of goodness or the news of sadness. It's not a good idea. Allah says, you need to know. Go back to Allah. Go back to His Messenger. Go back to those with knowledge. They would be able to guide you as to how to extract the rulings that would help you in your circumstance, in your situation. And Allah says, had it not been for the favor of Allah, many of you would have simply followed shaitan. May Allah protect us from shaitan. This is a good piece of advice. There are people, whether they have a problem at home, with their spouses, at the workplace, in the country, political, non-political, whatever it may be, if you're in a mess, there is no point in advertising that you're in a mess. Because, subhanAllah, the people's sympathy will not solve your problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us solve our matters, our problems, our issues. أقول قولي هذا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.